Good morning, class. We are welcome to this class, and today we are looking into rangeland management. Don't forget that the other time we look at pasture, and we look at the meaning of pasture, forage crop, the characteristics of pasture, importance of pasture, types of pasture that we have, and different way of managing grasses and legumes that can be cultivated or planted on pasture. Today we'll be looking into rangeland, which more or less close to pasture. When we are talking about rangeland management, that is, how can we manage rangeland? Rangeland is a large areas of land which is used for cultivation of forage crop, that is for practicing of pasture. That is what rangelands mean. And here we see that the is a term that's used to describe a predominantly herbaceous plant community, that is a large and intensive areas of land that is used for grazing of pasture animal, that is used for feeding grasses and legumes to animal like cattle, sheep and goat, that we describe under pasture. So a large areas of land, extensive large areas of land that is used for cultivation of or growing of grasses and legumes that we use for pasture is what refers to as rangeland. Now we'll be looking at the importance of pasture. What are the importance of pasture? The importance of pasture is that pasture is used for cultivation of grasses and legumes that we use for feeding livestock. And when we are talking about pasture under rangeland, we have artificial pasture and established pasture, or what we call natural pasture. We have artificial pasture that is also called established pasture, or improved pasture, or natural pasture, as I've explained to you under forage, pasture and forage crop. Artificial pasture is the pasture that grasses and legumes are growing there deliberately for the purpose of feeding our livestock. Why the improved or natural pasture is the one that grasses and legumes growing there are natural. They are not grown or planted by anybody. They are just there growing by the world, by the farmer. Now, importance of rangeland. What do we use rangeland to do? It's a source of food for livestock, especially ruminant animal. They provide cheap quality feed for animals, since most of the pasture are grown naturally. No one is cultivating them. No one is planting them. They are growing naturally on their own. And this is what is common. Hardly you see an improved pasture or established pasture, because the range of the portion of land used for cultivating of the grasses and legumes. So the another importance of rangeland is that free range is allowed for the animal to exercise themselves, to move freely from one point toward to another. And under rangeland, we can also use rangeland to reduce soil erosion or runoff, that is washing away of water, of nutrient by water or wind. When a land is not used for cultivation, we allow grasses and legumes to grow there. It preserves the nutrient in such environment, whereby the runoff or soil erosion will be reduced. Animals also have access under rangeland. Animals have access to varieties of forage crop, that is different species of grasses and legumes, different varieties of grasses and legumes in good quality to make their feed to be what? To be a balanced ration. And grasses and legumes in rangeland can also be cut and preserved as hay or silage for future use. That is, we can cut these grasses and legumes and store them, either giving to the animal in form of silage or in form of silage. What are the characteristics of rangeland? What are the characteristics of rangeland? Number one, they have high quality of grasses and legumes. That is, the grasses and legumes there contain nutrients because many things decay, organic matter decompose, and they add nutrients to the soil. The grasses and legumes, and they have high regenerative ability after they have been fed by the animal. The animal, when they feed on it, you see that the grasses and legumes, as time goes on, they grow in a short period of time, which means that they have highly regenerative ability. They contain no planted or sowing species plant, but naturally grown species. That is, there is no grasses and legumes growing there that is cultivated by someone, but they are naturally growing and they are of good species. They contain different grasses and legumes that the animal can eat and consume as their feed. Now, let's look at the common grasses and legumes that we have on rangeland that we can use to feed our livestock. But firstly, we are looking into grasses. The first one is Bahama grass, which the botanical name is Cynodon tatilon. The second one is elephant grass. The botanical name is Penicentum puperium. We have carpet grass, which is Asonopus compressus. We have giant star grass, which is Cynodon latostachyon. We have guinea grass, which is Panicum maximum. We have Centrosema under legumes. We have Centrosema, which is Centrosema pubensin. We have Calopo, which is Calopogonum mucunodus. And we have Mucuna, which is Mucuna utilisi. We have Tropical Kuzu, which is Pupera facilities. And we have Sun M, which is Cotalaria juncea. Now, we have some factors that affect the level of production of grasses and legumes, that is herbage, in the rangeland. Number one is rainfall. The amount of rain determines the level and the rate at which the grasses and legumes will grow, and that they will produce feed for the world, for the living, feeding of the livestock. Another factors that determine the productivities of grasses and legumes, forage crop at the rangeland, is the grasses and legumes mixture in pastures. That is the rangeland, that is the mixture of grasses and legumes planting together on a rangeland. It's very important for you as a farmer to cultivate or to allow grasses and legumes together to grow on your farmland, so that the legumes there helps in supplying nutrients to the soil. As you know that the root nodule of a leguminous crop helps in fixing nitrogen into the soil, and it increases the fertility of the soil, which improves the rapid growth of the animal. Rotational grazing is also one of the factors that determine productivity. So make sure you practice rotational grazing by dividing the rangeland into different paddocks, whereby the animal grazes on a certain paddock at a particular period of time. What is paddock? Paddock is the division of a rangeland into different units using a wire mesh or a bamboo tree to divide them, and you allow the animal to graze on a particular paddock for a period of time before they move to another paddock, continually like that till the end of the paddock. This is what we call rotational grazing. Overgrazing is also one of the factors that determine the productivities of grasses and legumes on the rangeland. That is, you must not allow the animal to graze on to overgraze on a particular areas of land, or you instock many animal more than the grazing ability. Grazing of rangeland must be carefully and well planned. All these are what they are factors that determine the productivities and the growing of crops, forage crop on the rangeland. Soil fertility also is very important. The fertility of the soil enhances growth of forage crop. Shady trees, you must allow shade trees to be on your farm to reduce direct sunning, scorching of sun, and which will increase the rate of evaporation of water. You also control weed on your farm, on your forage crop, on your rangeland. Method of rangeland and pasture improvement. How do you improve your rangeland so that there will be continuity in the grain of rangeland? Number one, control stocking. Make sure that you manage by knowing the numbers, the correct numbers of animal that should be allowed to graze on a particular area of land at a particular period of time, so that there will not be overstocking. So you control the stocking rate by knowing the actual number. Reseeding is also when you replant a seed or forage crop in a particular place you are expecting, or you know that a grass or legumes should grow, but it's not growing, or is showing a sign of dying or not growing well, you replace it with another plant. This is what we refer to as reseeding. You reseed the plant by planting another plant, another seed of forage crop there. Fertilizer application. Application of fertilizer, or you can be manure, or it can be inorganic manure. And irrigation is also important. That is, supplying water to your farmland at regular basis. These are the things that you have to know under the use of rangeland and the animal husbandry, that rearing of animal. These are the wonderful questions for you that you can practice on your own as your assignment. What is rangeland? State 5 importance and 5 characteristics of rangeland. Briefly explain the factors affecting the level of production of rangeland, of forage crop on rangeland. List 4 common grasses and legumes and their common and their botanical names. Discuss the practice of paddocking as a way of improving rangeland. God bless you. We'll stop here till we meet next time. God bless you. It is well with you. Amen.